let's continue our conversation on the phases and funnels and break those down into the processes themselves. So in each of the funnels, we had different steps, and those steps can then be further broken down into a process. And it's in these processes where effectively the rubber meets the road. This is where the stakeholders are actually taking action. So we have internal stakeholders that might be processing something to help the company move forward. Likewise, we might have external stakeholders that need to engage in some behavior in order to move forward with the company. But effectively, the process is allowing us to make those steps happen and outline what needs to take place in order for that process to be completed. In a digital world, then that process is going to be facilitated and tied into devices and software. And essentially, it's those components, the devices and software, that will allow the process to move forward in a digital space. It's going to be tied into the data, and then the data is what we're going to have on the back end that will allow us to kind of look at the process and what's happening. And then the software and the device provide a nice way to interact with that medium. The processes are going to vary based on the stakeholder. For example, even internal stakeholders with different jobs will have different processes. So if we look at a sales process, for example, or a sales funnel, the sales rep is going to have one set of steps and processes that they need to take to work with that client in order to make the purchase happen and to make things move forward. Once that process takes place, then there's likely other stakeholders, say warehouse workers or inventory workers, that then need to go and compile all of the different components in order to fulfill that purchase. And so we have one process leading into another one, or we have different stakeholders participating in different processes in order to help the company reach the same goal, in this case, a successful sale. Likewise, we can also have the processes differentiate based on the funnel. So for example, as we saw before, internal and external stakeholders have different funnels that they're going to work through as they work with the company. Those different funnels then have different steps and actions that need to be completed. And so just by the nature of the funnel and its position with the company is going to impact how it is that people take steps to move forward with that funnel. So essentially, the processes are what we need in the funnels in order to make the steps happen, to make the stakeholders move from point A to point B. They work through the layers of the company, then through the steps in the funnel, and then through each of the different processes in those steps in order to reach an end goal. So next, we'll talk about how devices can also play into these different phases.